I know the band members will like never fucking see this video, but I just hope they keep continuing to make music and they never stop, because it's like insane like how fucking involved I am in their music. Like, I fucking love it. Like, I'm just so fucking happy for Knightley, and I can't wait to see where they go from here. Welcome to the channel. My name is Kyra, and in today's video I'm going to be doing something very special to me. I'm just so excited. So today, you know, to celebrate, I have on my Perception shirt. I'm just so in love with their music, and I listen to it constantly, and I'm just so thankful that they were the openers. I'd be lit as fuck just listening to their music, just chilling, you know what I'm saying? So a big reason why I wanted to start this YouTube channel was because I wanted to document all of my concert experiences and just put them all in one place together. Today I'm going to be talking about an experience that I am extremely grateful that I had, and that is getting to meet Knightley and seeing them perform live. So I went to two NF concerts, the NF Perception Tour. I went to one in February and I went to one in October, and Knightley opened for both of them. And I'm so fucking thankful that Knightley was the opener, because I like vibe with their music so much. Like, all I do with my life is literally listen to NF, Knightley, and like Black Bear. Like, that's literally all I do. And watch YouTube videos. So, hey. So I was first introduced to Knightley at the NF Perception Tour in February, and ever since I started listening to their music that night, I fucking loved it. And I haven't stopped since. Like, I literally have a problem. I will just pick a person or a group and just fucking listen to their shit and only their shit. And that's what I do with NF and Knightley and Black Bear, so. I'm so thankful that I got to meet them before they like blew up. And the bitch, it was free! Not the tickets, but I got to meet them for free. Like, they stayed after the concert and like signed shit. I'm so happy that I got to meet them. Knightley deserves their own video, because I've literally been obsessing over them for like over a year now, and I got weed on my lip. I think I have weed on my throat now. Okay, bitch. Anyway. I feel like Knightley deserves their own video, because I've literally been obsessing with them for like over a year now, and I'm just so excited that I got to meet them. So excited. Like, I don't look forward to much. Like, all I look forward to is weed and YouTube, so. Concerts, I'm glad that I could add Knightley and NF to the list of things that make me happy. I have problems. Anyway, moving on. So I was lucky enough to get front row at both of these concerts, because your bitch is dedicated and your bitch waited outside in 18 degree weather for way too fucking long, and your bitch almost got frostbit both times. Like, literally, I wanted to cry. It was completely worth it, and I still would have went to the hospital if I got frostbit anyway after the concert, so shit. I loved it. I'm so happy that this happened. Like, everyone like bitches like, why do you spend your money on this shit? Bitch! It's an experience that I'm going to have forever. Well, not really, because I'm gonna smoke enough weed and I'm gonna forget about it, but that's why I'm gonna make this video, so I can remember it and keep it forever. So the first time that I seen them was February 5th in Grand Rapids, and that was at 20 Monroe Live. And the second time that I seen them was October 7th, and that was in Chicago, Illinois, at Aragon Ballroom. So for the Grand Rapids show, I was literally like the third person in line, and I made friends with this one girl, Brianna. She's on my Snapchat. I haven't talked to her in like a year, but what's up, Brianna? How you doing? You're not watching this, but anyway. Anyway, I made a couple friends in line, even though I don't really like talking to people, but I made a couple friends. And this girl named Brianna, she gave me some hand warmers, which is really nice of her, because we were literally freezing to death, like Michigan in February, bitch. Come on. Come on. Fuck that. Like, all the way fuck that. Fuck that shit. Worth it, though. Just saying. There were also these two girls who were the first two girls in line, and I just kept calling them blanket bitches, because they were all snuggled up in their blankets, and I was just, like, in my head calling them blanket bitches the whole time, because I was jealous. Because I wanted their fucking blankets. But I ended up talking to them after, because they seen me take some edibles, and they were like, hey, are those edibles? What you doing? And they were really cool to talk to. Like, they became my little buddy line friends, too. But I was still jealous of them fucking blankets. So for the Grand Rapids concert, I literally went by myself, and I have social anxiety, and I can't even go to the grocery store by myself, but I went to the NF concert by myself because I just had to. Like, you literally cannot miss out on NF because your friends don't fuck with him. Like, don't do that to yourself, please. Like, if you are scared to go to a concert by yourself, just do it. Like, you will make friends with the people around you, and if not, just keep to yourself and listen to music in line, you know? Earphones, don't talk to nobody, that's cool too. But for the first concert, my mom and her friend Baron drove me. So they dropped me off and they went on their merry way to Gun Lake Casino. And after they drove all the way to the casino, I called their asses because I got 2 free tickets in line. Like, some guy just came out and was like, hey, who wants these tickets? And I was like, me, bitch. The guy was literally like, who has 2 friends that wants to go see NF? And I was like, I don't have friends, but I have parents, like, is that cool? He like, bitch, that's cool. And I was the first one to raise my hand up in that bitch. The blanket bitches wanted them, which I feel really bad about that. I feel bad for calling them blanket bitches, but like, you know, blankets. I'm just so high and excited, and I love NF, and I love Nightly, and this is too much. I'm so excited. Just like thinking about this memory that happened like a year ago, over a year ago, I'm just so happy that I got to see them. So yeah, I ended up getting 2 free tickets, and I got that's 3, but I ended up getting 2 free tickets, and my mom and Baron got to go see the concert, and it was his first concert. This guy's like 30, and it was his first concert, and he was so hyped and so excited, and he was so happy. They were all the way in the back because they were at Gun Lake Casino, and they were almost like, they were like about to chill in the casino, and then I called their asses right when they got to the casino. I was like, hey, turn around, like, drive almost an hour back or however long and bring your asses here. We're finna have a lit ass time at the NF concert, but I'm finna have it by myself because I'm with all these random people. But yeah, so yeah, they were in the back, but they still enjoyed it. His favorite song was Green Lights, and my mom always loves like Let You Down. She loves like the typical songs, you know, but I'm really happy that they got to go too. It was really cool. So when we got into the concert, I rushed my ass up in that bitch and I got to the front row, but I didn't get in the middle. I could have been like 3 or 4 people back and been in the middle, but I decided to take my ass off to the side because I wanted to be near the cage, and this kind of backfired on me because he wasn't near me that much, but you know, I was still front row and I still got to see him, so bitch is excited. So for the second trip to Chicago, this was way further, and this trip went totally fucking wrong. Like, I need to do a whole separate story time on how fucking terrible this trip was. Like, we almost got robbed. Actually, we did get robbed. The friend with us did get robbed. He kind of got kidnapped. Like, the car broke down. It rained like fucking crazy. Our Airbnb was in the ghetto. Like, it was just too much. Like, too much bullshit happened on this trip. Like, I can't. Some guy tried to sell us drugs and then tried to buy drugs from us. Like, the trip was terrible, but it was all worth it because I got to go see NF and Nightly. So, Chicago was a fucking trip. Like, Chicago was something else. I get so pissed off just thinking about the Chicago trip because I wasted so much money on bullshit, like straight up bullshit. Not because of the concert, but some other bullshit. Bullshit. But we're not gonna talk about the bullshit, we're gonna talk about the amazing time that I had at the concert and the only reason why I'm like alive. Was that too much? I don't know. What's kind of crazy is though, I was the very first person up in that bitch to stand in line because I got there at like 10 a.m. and my ass had to pee and my ass had to eat, so I got out of line because no one else was there. So I came back like a couple hours later and bitch, tell me why there was like 20, 30 people in line. I was like, damn. But like, I literally waited there like at 10 a.m. I waited there for like 2 hours or something and nobody came. So I was like, I need to go take my ass somewhere and take care of shit, you know? I came back and there were so many people in line and I was so fucking mad. While I was waiting though, like, the security guards were staring me down the whole time, but like, it's cool, whatever. Like, I'm a fangirl, you know? But I swear I like heard him talking. Like, I heard him practicing and I was trying to take a video of it, but the shit wasn't going down because this girl, she gave me a beer while I was walking down there and I spilled it in my purse and the security guard was staring at me and I was like high as fuck and I was like, oh my god, I can't do this, and I just had so much anxiety, so a bitch had to leave. So anyway, long story short, I ended up going to this concert with my best friend and his best friend and this random bitch that he met on Tinder like 2 days prior. Like, bitch, why are you bringing her? I mean, she was nice and all, but why? You know? She was great. Like, hey, you're great, but Why, Josh? He literally left me with her the entire trip. Like, he didn't even talk to her the whole time. I'm like, bitch. Ugh, bitch. So anyway, my ass was invested in this concert, and the only reason we took this trip was to go to see NF and Knightley, and none of them were into it, none of them. So my ass waited in line by myself, and I made buddy line friends with the people near me. They gave me some pizza. They were awesome. You guys are great. Good looking. They literally went back home to the Airbnb to take naps while I waited in line all day because they're some bitches, you know? And while they got to the Airbnb, the car fucking broke down and they had to take an Uber to the concert, and they were all the way in the back. They were all the way at the top while I was in the front row. Like, look at their view and look at my view. Like, all because they wanted to go home and take a nap. Like, y'all couldn't wait. We drove all this way. We drove all this way. And the guy that we were with, which we ain't talking about him because he's something else. He's something else. He still owes me money. We're not about to talk about that. But anyway, like, the guy that we were with, like, he literally walked out of the concert. He only seen, like, barely any of it. And my friend was chasing him down the whole time. I didn't know any of this till after the fact. But, bitch, I can't be bothered because my ass was front row. And I was there prepared, bitch. My ass was prepared to see this shit, okay? I was prepared. I literally planned this trip out. Like, of course I'm gonna get front row. Like, I made it there early on purpose. I woke up at 4 a.m. on purpose. We drove there early at the crack of dawn on purpose to get there early in front row, you know? Anyway, I had a great time, so yeah. So anyway, let's just not talk about the bullshit that I had to endure during this trip. Like, that will be in a different video. So anyway, back to Knightley. So Knightley is a band that is fucking amazing, may I just fucking add. So they're made up of three members, Jonathan Capecchi, and I probably said that wrong, but he's the lead singer, cute as fuck. There's also Joey Beretta, and he's the guitarist, and they're actually cousins, which I just found out, which is awesome. Like, they've been doing music since they were 11, and they started in Philadelphia, where they were born, I think. And they also have a third member, and his name is Nicholas Sonato, and he is the drummer of the band. And he actually liked one of my tweets, like, after the concert, back at, like, whenever it happened. He's really dope. They all are. Like, they were so nice meeting. I bought a CD and they signed it, like, bitch. I love it. Like, who really listens to CDs? But, like, I will definitely cherish this shit and keep it on my wall. Like, I literally just, not on my wall, don't keep it on your wall. Like, don't put it on your wall, come on. I literally just keep it on my desk over there and stand it up, and I cherish it. I love it. I'm actually gonna show you my CD right quick. So we got the outside with the signatures on it, and then it's just a Knightley plain black and white, and it's very sleek, and it's very my style, and it's very MF style. Like, it's very everyone's style, you know? It's my style. Anyway, I'm a fucking mess. Point is, I fucking love this. We have Miss You Like Hell, XO, Holding On, Stay, and No Vacancy. And I'm in love with all of those except for the last one. Especially Stay, I'm, like, really in love with. Like, in love with. They're actually signed to, like, the same record label that NF is signed to, and their Honest EP came out in 2016, but I didn't start listening to them until, like, 2018 when the concert was. But I'm just really thankful that I finally got to discover their music because they're fucking amazing, and, like, all I do is listen to their music. Like, fuck, it's really rare that I'm, like, into an opening artist, like, that fucking much, like, as much as the fucking headliner. Like, bitch, I'm so excited. I'm so happy that I got to meet them before they were, like, you know? I literally love every single song that they played during their set list, like, every single one. There's only one that they came out with after the fact that I was like, eh. But, like, every single other song I'm a fucking obsessed with. Like, Miss You Like Hell, what else is there? We got Talk To Me, we got EXO, bitch. Stay, which is, like, Still Think About You, is probably one of my favorites because, bitch, just listen to it. Like, if you just listen to their fucking music, bitch, you will be feeling it. You, trust me. Trust me. Just listen, okay? Just give it a chance. Who Am I To You? Like, that's also a dope-ass song. And, like, Faded, bitch. They also have a song called Faded, and they never released it. Like, they play it during their set list, but it's not on Apple Music. Like, how come I can't listen to it every day? Like, I have to listen to the few seconds that I have of it. Like, can you please, like, I'm gonna need y'all to please, like, release it on Apple Music or, like, record it. Like, come on. Can you do me that favor? Like, please? That's all I want. Thank you. So when it comes to meeting them, I'm, like, so happy that I got to finally meet them. Like, for the first concert, I was literally too fucking scared to meet them. I was like, I could not possibly, like, touch him and hug them. Like, who am I to do that, you know? Who am I to you? I like literally just had so much anxiety, I could not meet them to save my life. So that was in February and I did not meet them because I just ran straight for the door. I ran out, I was like, bye bitch, bye. I seen you live, but I gotta go. Like, I can't do this. But when it comes to the second concert, your bitch had to meet them, because at that point, like, I was a fan. Like, I was like diehard listening to their music a lot. Like, so I had to get a picture. Like, I just had to. I had to talk to them, put their arm around me. Oh my god, so excited. I'm a fucking fangirl. Please shut the fuck up, Kyra. Anyway. So yeah, meeting them, I met them in Chicago. That was a really awesome experience, and I was super fucking nervous. I didn't know what to say. I didn't say really anything. Not like I've been listening to you for a year now. Not like I was fucking dancing and singing the whole time when no one else around me was. There's actually one girl behind me who was like into it, but everyone else was like, who are these people? I'm like, they're Nightly, come on. Like, I just screamed. I didn't need to scream, but like, come on guys. I'm gonna need y'all to be a little bit more energetic. Like, I'm gonna need y'all to bounce with me. Like, come on, let's do this. Come on, like, get hype for NF. I know you don't know who they are, but like, bounce, bitch. You know, bounce. I'm fucking on one today. What was I talking about? I'm fucking too high for this shit. So yeah, also meeting them, I was also by myself when I was meeting them, and my phone was literally on 1%. My phone rarely ever stays on 1%, but this night, my phone stayed on 1% for like a good 20 minutes because, bitch, I don't know what happened. Like, because all my chargers were dead. Like, none of them charged while I was in the car, so I didn't even get like half the footage that I wanted to get. That's a whole other fucking like dilemma that I'm pissed about, but that 1% battery fucking came through for your bitch. Like, your bitch got her picture. But it's insane because I was literally the last person in line to meet them. Like, the security guard came up and was like, okay, we gotta go, 10 minutes, whatever. And I was like, can I still meet you though? Like, can you like wait a second? They totally waited, and they were totally sweet and amazing, and I got to meet them, and it was great. I don't even know where I was going with that. Meeting them was fucking awesome. That's all I really have to say, I guess. It was so awkward though. Like, I guess we're like almost the same height, but I was kneeling down in the picture because I was like, I don't know why, I was just bending down in the picture instead of standing straight up because I'm a dumb bitch. And I was like, oh, I felt bad, like, because he had his arm around me, so I felt bad about like moving. I didn't want to move his arm, you know. I just overthink too much and have problems, but I'm glad I have that picture, even though I look fucking stupid in it. So yeah, I think I finally talked enough about my concert experience. I think it went pretty great. Even though, like, everything went wrong during my Chicago trip, it was a really amazing experience, and I'm glad that I got to go. I'm so happy that I got to meet them and see them. They're also on a headlining tour right now. Bitch, go check them out if you haven't already. Actually, they only have, like, a week worth of shows left, depending on when I edit this video. I'm so proud of them. They got their own headlining tour, bitch. Like, look at you. Okay, I see you out here. I see you out here Nightly. You're doing your thing. Okay. I didn't get to go to it, but I got to see them twice already, so that's still pretty cool, you know? If you have a chance to go see Nightly in the future, or NF, or like anyone that you love, even if it's by yourself, please fucking go. I'm so fucking happy that I discovered them and that I got to see them live. Hopefully I get to see them again one day on a new headline tour. You know, that'd be pretty fucking awesome. And hopefully they come closer to me. Come to Kalamazoo, Michigan. It's probably too small. So maybe like Grand Rapids. Like, maybe we can try that again. Actually, Kalamazoo's cool. I don't know. I'm just really excited that I got to discover a new band that I'm really in love with and that I can just listen to their music all day. It's rare that I find like a band or an artist that I will just like binge listen to for like hours and hours. And Nightly is definitely one of them. Along with NF, of course. Like, so if you actually made it to the end of this video, then thank you so much for watching it. Don't forget to give it a like and subscribe down below for future videos if you enjoyed it. And if you didn't, then that's okay too, because I can just look back at this video and think about my fond memories at my Nightly concert. So there's that. I'll always have that, you know? So yeah, I think I've talked enough about how amazing the concert was. So if you want to see my Nightly concert footage from the two concerts that I went to, one in Grand Rapids and Chicago, then keep watching. Cause you've been stuck in my head. Tried to open up about it. Called a friend to clear my conscience. They said
got a new man.
Thank you.
be hanging out after the show downstairs at our merch table, so please come say hey to us. Once again, we're a band called Nightly. This is our last song. It's called XO.
So much.
Woo!